to the Nic Nice Show. I am your host, Nic Nice, and I cannot tell you what a pleasure it is to be here with you all. And the fact that you all chose to be here with me, you know what I mean? I'm blushing right now, but you can't tell. Anyways, let me tell you a little something about the Nic Nice Show, okay? Not only are you going to get amazing interviews with amazingly, awesomely nice people, like today's guest, Koereyelle Dubose of the Single Wives Club, but you're also going to get music videos, you know what I mean? If you're like me, you'll have a chance to catch all the video shows. So I'm going to show you the top three when it comes to hip-hop, R&B, pop, whatever it is that's basically out there and it's hot. Or nice, as we say around here. And we also have the Nice List where we talk about, you know, the daily topics, what's hot, entertainment, lifestyle, pop culture, and all that. And then we end the show with Said Nicely. But since we're at the top of the show, before we get to our amazing guests and awesome music videos, first up, we have the Nice List.
You and your boo.
How y'all doing?
What boo?
Nico.
I love the way Nicks insinuate this.
Have you ever made sex tape?
First up is the Mimi and Nico sex tape, which really should be called the Mimi sex tape because for the most part, I don't know anybody who's really checking for Nico, right? It's really all about Mimi, but he's in it though, so I guess they had to put his name up there. But by now, everybody's talking about and has heard or maybe even watched the infamous Mimi and Nico sex tape. The funny thing to me about this whole situation is how shower rods have all of a sudden just blown up, right? I mean, I've seen everything from memes to parodies and spoofs about the shower rod. And I guess, you know, when you go to hotels, they actually do have really good shower rods. I don't know how many of y'all have been to hotels, but if you go to them, especially the decent ones, you know, they actually kind of bolted in. Not the ones at your crib that, you know, if you pull on it from the, you know, the sides, it'll come off. No, that's not the kind of shower rods they have there. Probably for liability, you know, purposes.
The way I define my success is how many people I'm able to affect their lives in a positive way.
There's also been this brouhaha about P. Diddy, a.k.a. Puff Daddy, a.k.a. Puff, a.k.a. Sean Combs, a.k.a. Can you stop coming up with new names for a second, right? I mean, there's been a brouhaha about him speaking at the commencement at Howard University. Now, P. Diddy did go to Howard, but he did not graduate. And for that reason, some people are a little perturbed. And then there's some people who are upset because, you know, he was associated with the shooting with J-Lo, and he's a rapper and all this, that, and the third. Now, if you ask me, which nobody did, but I want to give you my advice anyway, the fact that he went to Howard to me is cool, right? Because he actually went there. But the fact that he's a successful person, right? So you have this graduating class of people who are getting ready to go out there and conquer the world. And here's somebody who went out there and did his thing. Now, judge him for whatever else or not, but to not include him or not want him included in the commencement to me would be a bad idea. And shout out to Howard for saying, you know what? Take that. And speaking of which, if he was at my commencement speech and he was giving out, you know, shots of Ciroc, I would take that too. All right. So for all the people who got a problem with Diddy speaking at the commencement speech, take that. Anyways, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. You're watching the Nic Nice Show. We'll be right back after this.
The Nic Nice Show, sponsored by Hennessey DS. Never stop, never settle.
Next thing, and you got something that people should see, it's important that you go all the way with it so that you get it out there for people to see. The whole world's waiting for it, you know. Don't wait on the world. Get started. Get busy. Go. Never stop. Never settle.
The Nice Three. Number three.
First things first, I'm the realest. Drop this and let the whole world feel it.
Let them feel it.
And I'm still in the murder business. I can hold you down like I'm giving lessons in physics.
Right.
You should want a bad bitch like this.
Huh?
Drop it low and pick it up just like this.
Yeah.
Cup of Ace, cup of Goose, cup of Chris. I heal something worth a half a ticket on my wrist.
On my wrist.
Taking all the liquor straight. Never chase that.
Never.
Stop like we bring an 88 back.
What?
Bring the hooks in where the bass at. Champagne spilling, you should taste that.
I'm so fancy. You already know I'm in the fast lane. From LA to Tokyo. I'm so fancy. Can't you taste this gold? Remember my name. Let you blow.
Welcome back to the Nic Nice Show. Like I mentioned before, we have an amazing guest joining us today, and I wanted to have her on because as a man, I think it's important to hear women out, and I have a love for women. And so we're going to have a single lady joining us to talk about what it's like for single ladies out there. Koereyelle Dubose of the Single Wives Club, thank you for joining us on the Nic Nice Show. How are you?
Hey, Nick. How are you?
We're definitely happy to have you on. And, you know, we want to talk to you about that single life. But before we do that, can you tell our audience a little bit about you, your organization, and what led you to starting it?
So I'm Koereyelle Dubose, the founder and CEO of the Single Wives Club, which is an education and empowerment organization that prepares single women to become wives. And so our mission is to prepare single women to become wives, to nurture femininity, and to protect family. And honestly, it didn't start as a business scheme. It started out of personal need. After I ended an engagement in 2010, I wanted to figure out what I needed to do so that I would be prepared to become a wife, because I realized I just didn't have my stuff together, and that ending the engagement was the best decision I could make. And so from there, I started to do a lot of soul searching, wanted to learn the basics, started to try to learn how to cook. And me and my girlfriend started to getting together for these parties, and we started discussing these other areas that we needed to improve in, or skills that we needed to learn so that we could be prepared to become wives. And the rest is history.
Now, one of the reasons why we wanted to have you on was to talk about the single life from a single lady's perspective. So to be clear, are you single?
I am single, single until I'm married.
It seems to me there's a lot of amazing women out there that are single, especially Black women. Now, why do you think that is?
I definitely think that more Black women find ourselves single because we create this strict list and this box that we want Mr. Right to fit in. You know, he's going to be this height, he's going to have this much money, he's going to drive this car, he's going to go to this school, and we limit ourselves. It's very hard to find somebody that fits into that box. Whereas men and other cultures of women are much more open-minded. You know, they're not looking for that one thing. They're looking for somebody who will be a part of their life and who could fit into, you know, the life that they want to live. And I think that's one thing that we as Black women have to do, is stop limiting ourselves by what he looks like, what kind of car we think he's going to pull up in, even his skin tone. You know, you might have to take a walk to the other side of town and get outside of that box. So I just think that Black women have to stop limiting ourselves.
Now, something else out there that I hear women say all the time is, I got standards. The word standards, right? And I understand having standards, but it seems like some women take that to the extreme. Now, what do you think of that?
I think there's a big difference between standards or preferences and things that you know, there's a difference between preferences and priorities. What is most important to you, that would obviously be your priority. Preferences, that's height, that's skin complexion, that's the type of hair. You know, those are the superficial things. So I think that knowing, you know, having those two things straight, you know, this is what I want, this is what I can live without, this is what I absolutely cannot live without. But you don't have to be so strict and ridiculous with the standards that you have.
There's a song that goes, I-N-D-E-P-E-N-E-E, you know, I don't want to, you know, misspell the word, but basically the concept is celebrating women that are independent. Now, do you think that some women take that concept too far, to where it comes off like, you know what, I don't need a man, hence I'm not able to attract one?
Absolutely. And I think that is the number one reason why a lot of successful women are single, is because they have made up in their mind that they can do everything themselves. They don't need a man. And so if you've cut yourself off from that, it's obvious you're not attracting that. You know, you're not open to receiving a man if you're saying that I don't want one or I don't need one. And I think there's a very big difference between being independent and knowing that you can do everything on your own, and knowing that, okay, I'm independent now, but one day I want to transition into being interdependent and having someone who has my back, who is my better half, who, you know, who I can share my life with. And I think there's a big difference between the two.
We have to take a quick break, but we'll be right back with Koereyelle Dubose of the Single Wives Club.
The Nic Nice Show, sponsored by Hennessy VS. Never stop, never settle.
New York girl, them a mad over way. 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 Dance it down, dance it down, dance it down, dance it down. New York City,
Nice 3, number 2.
Talking with Koereyelle Dubose of the Single Wives Club, and we're having a great conversation that's about to get nicer. Anyways, when it comes to dating and sex, do you think there's a certain amount of time that women should wait, like i.e. the 90-day rule? Why or why not?
I feel like if you have this preset date in your mind, like, okay, I'm marking off the days on the calendar, you don't know what's going to happen in that 90 days. Like, you don't know that anything is going to be different from day one to day 90. You don't know if he's going to pretend like everything is good until those 90 days. I mean, I just feel like having anything made up in your mind before you ever even give it a chance, that is where we go wrong. You know, we put that's another one of those boxes. We put ourselves in that box, and then we convince ourselves, like, if he doesn't stick around until day 91, then he's not the man for me, which again, you don't know. You never know. So I don't believe in the rules. I think that you should do what you're comfortable with, what you can wake up, you know, the next day feeling okay about, and have fun, but be safe.
With the proliferation of the internet, social media, you have apps now. I mean, how do you feel about online dating, and should that be an option for today's single lady?
I've tried it, I have to say, and you know, I say it was an experiment because I am the single wife. I have this organization. I feel like I have to, you know, I have to know everything that's going on. I have to at least experience a little bit of everything. And so I put a profile out there, but I tell you, it's not any better than the club. You know, I felt like, and specifically, I probably picked the wrong one, but I just felt like it was bad pickup lines. You know, it was the same old stuff, but online. And I wasn't interested. And honestly, I don't know if I would be interested in a man who felt like he had to pay a monthly fee and put a profile online. I don't know. It's not for me, but I have heard success stories. I do, you know, have a couple friends who have met decent people off the internet. It's just not for me.
I see that you guys have these shirts, right? It says like men over boys. And I mean, it's cute. You know what I mean? So can you tell us a little bit about the acronyms and what exactly does that phrase mean?
Yes. So men over boys, that is our movement. And we say that a man is someone who meets all needs and a boy is a burden on you. And I'm sure you ladies out there have come across those boys, and you can distinguish the men from the boys easily by what they say, by how they act, by the conversation. I mean, it's very clear. It's very easy. A boy will show himself without a doubt, hands down. First date, you might not even have to go that far. But I just feel like we deal with way too much foolishness. You know, we are letting these men, or these boys, I should say, get away with just such silly stuff. And I know that we're doing it because they come to me thinking that stuff is normal. And I'm like, what women are out here letting y'all think that, you know, it's okay to ask me, do I love sex on the first date? Cut it out, you know, but somebody out there is letting these men do that or these boys do that. And so they're coming to the good women and we're not going for it. And so the mob movement is all about setting standards for men instead of settling for boys.
So what can we expect next from the Single Wives Club, and where can people go to get more information?
You can connect with the Single Wives online at thesinglewivesclub.com, and you can catch our weekly radio show every Wednesday, 6 to 7 p.m. Eastern at thesinglewivesclub.com. We also have an interactive talk show that airs every fourth Tuesday at thesinglewivesclub.com/TV. We always have events going on here in Atlanta. We're looking forward to moving nationwide with our events, and we're always looking for happy wives to join our mentoring program, The Wives Society. Those applications, as well as membership applications, are available online at thesinglewivesclub.com.
Thank you for joining us today.
Thanks, Nick, for having me.
But don't go anywhere. We have much more coming up. You're watching The Nic Nice Show.
The Nic Nice Show, sponsored by Tennessee DS. Never stop, never settle.
Next thing, you got something that people should see. It's important that you go all the way with it so that you get it out there for people to see. The whole world's waiting for it. You know, don't wait on the world. Get started, get busy, go. Never stop, never settle.
The Nice Three, number one.
And finally, we end the show with Said Nicely. Today's topic is 420. Now, you know, 420 was April 20th that just passed this weekend, but it's also a code that the marijuana subculture uses frequently, particularly like 420 celebrating a holiday on April 20th, but also the time of day. So if somebody happens to be watching this as 420, I'm sure you can pause for a second, get your smoke on it, come right back. The reason why I bring this up today is because to me, 420 is a great cause for conservatives to pick up. And for me, I don't understand why they haven't done so already, right? Because if you look at the issue with marijuana, that's not to say that some conservatives haven't picked up the issue. I'm just saying, like, overall, it should be like a matter of thing. And maybe it gets us a couple of extra votes of 2016, because you know that's coming, right? The idea that 420 fits a lot of conservatives principles to me just makes a lot of sense, right? So for example, personal liberty. Like, I should be able to just sit on my porch or in my home or in the privacy of my own area and smoke a joint. Like, it's just me doing it personally, and I should have the liberty to do so without, number two, government infringement, right? So small government. The prison industrial complex has been filled with people who are nonviolent drug offenders who basically want to get a toke on here and there, who aren't bothering nobody. But now you put big government in there, you're locking people up. And so that's the second principle that 420 happens to coincide, right? Then you have the free market. Free market as in, you know what, I have some supplies, I have some soil, I have some seeds, I can go out there and plant me a couple of plants and maybe sell a couple and be able to pay off my mortgage or my health insurance for smoking the weed in the first place, right? Or even if you look at it from a state rights perspective, where basically states like Colorado and Washington are basically being able to do their own thing because they decided that they wanted to make money and raise tax revenue by allowing the sale and the use of recreational marijuana. To me, any way you slice it, this is high time for the Conservative Party to be get behind something that not only will help them get votes and help them become a little bit cooler, but also something that really is in fact true to conservative principles. And to me, that is Said Nicely. Thanks again for joining us. I cannot tell you how excited I am that you all decide to spend your time with your boy, Nic Nice. I also want to thank my very amazing guest, Koereyelle Dubose of the Single Wives Club. It was an amazing conversation. Definitely make sure you check her out. We'll be coming back in May, so look out for us because the Nic Nice Show is coming. And I want to thank you again for joining us. And again, tell a friend and make sure you join us again in May. Until then, I'll see you next time.